Today, we will understand the edges and corners of shapes. Bablu had hidden Chanda's most loved big walnut, and Chanda had been given instructions in the letter to look for the walnut. Chanda read the letter. "I have hidden your biggest walnut. If you want to find your walnut, then reach the well with any object with three edges and three corners." Chanda had no idea about edges and corners. She rushed to Big Mouth Uncle's house. She asked Uncle that what is meant by edges and corners. "Children, do you know about edges and corners? Any idea?" "No problem. Let us also learn the concepts of edges and corners from Uncle." Uncle showed the table at his place. "See that outside the surface of this table, four lines are forming the boundary of the table. We call them edges. And do you know what is meant by corners? Where two edges meet, we call that point as a corner." Uncle asks Chanda that how many edges and corners are there on this rectangular table. "Children, do you know the answer?" "Yes, four edges and four corners." Then Chanda told Uncle that she is looking for an object that has three edges and three corners. Uncle made these three shapes on paper. "Children, do you recognize these shapes?"
"Yes,
this is a rectangle. This is a square. And this is a triangle." Now, Uncle asked Chanda to recognize the objects with three edges and three corners. "Do you recognize this shape?"
"Absolutely right. Triangle.
Triangle has three edges and three corners." "Children, can you tell me if the edges of these shapes are made of straight lines or are they curved?" "Yes, the edges of these shapes are made of straight lines." Now Uncle said to Chanda that if she wants the solution to the puzzle, then she has to look for one triangular shaped object. "Children, can you find such an item in Uncle's house?"
"Oh wow, kids, you found it."
Now Chanda reached the well along with the hanger. Chanda closed her eyes. Seeing this, Bablu came out from behind the well and kept the walnut in front of Chanda and ran away from there. When Chanda opened her eyes and found her walnut, she started dancing with joy. Children, in this lesson, we learned about the edges and corners of shapes. Children, in the previous video, we learned about the edges and corners of shapes. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of the same. Today, Babban has again come to Appu's shop to eat sweets for free. Babban said to Appu that he will play a game with him. He can quickly tell among the sweets or snacks how many edges and how many corners they have. If the answer is right, then Appu will let Babban eat the sweet for free. But if he gives the wrong answer, then he will pay the amount for that sweet to Appu. Appu agreed. Appu first gave Babban a piece of a burfi. Babban immediately said, 12 corners and 8 edges. Is Babban's answer correct? This is how the piece of burfi looks. Can you tell how many edges and how many corners does it have? Here are the edges. How many edges are there in total? 12. And how many corners? 8. Babban's answer is absolutely correct. He quickly ate the burfi. Now Appu gave Babban a kaju katli. Babban thought for a while. Children, can you also, along with Babban, think how many edges and corners does the kaju katli have? A kaju katli looks like this. Can you say which are the edges of this sweet? Yes, these are the edges of the sweet. How many edges in total? Now, can you make out which are the corners of the sweet? Here are the corners. How many total corners? 8. Babban answered this one correctly. And he quickly ate up the kaju katli too. Children, before Appu's next question, amongst all of these shapes, can you recognize the shape which has no corners? This is the right answer. These shapes have no corners. Now Appu had understood Babban's trick. This time he gave Babban a peda. Babban was confident that this time too he will answer correctly. So he quickly ate the peda. Now Babban started thinking. He answered that a peda has no corners and no edges. Children, is Babban's answer correct? This is how a peda looks. Can you recognize its curved edge? Correct. This is the curved edge of a peda. A curved edge. And corner? Yes, a peda does not have a corner. Appu explained the correct answer to Babban and took money for the peda from him. At last, Babban learnt a lesson. Children, in this lesson, we saw some interesting examples about the edges and corners of shapes. this video, we will see common mistakes related to the edges and corners of shapes. Raju, Bablu and Meenu are playing a unique game. Raju will tell Meenu and Bablu the number of edges and corners of shapes. Meenu and Bablu will have to make a shape according to the question asked. Raju's first question is such a shape which has four edges and four corners. Meenu and Bablu both start making their shapes. Meenu made this shape and Bablu has made this shape. Children, can you say, out of the two, whose shape is correct? Come, let us see Meenu's shape first. How many edges does Meenu's shape have? Four. And how many corners? Four. So is Meenu's shape correct? Yes, it is. Come on, now let us have a look at Bablu's shape. Can you recognize the curved edges of Bablu's shape? Yes, you have recognized them correctly. How many total curved edges are there? Four. Now, can you recognize the corners of Bablu's shape? Yes, correct. Bablu has made a shape where the corners are meeting two curved edges. How many corners are there in total? Four. So is Bablu's shape correct as well? Yes, Bablu's shape is correct as well. Raju's next question is such a shape which has two curved edges but no corners. Meenu and Bablu start thinking. Children, can you make such a shape? Come, let us see which shapes have Meenu and Bablu made. This is Meenu's shape. Children, can you say how many edges are there in Meenu's shape? Two edges. Perfect answer. Meenu's shape has one curved edge and one straight edge. Can you look for corners in Meenu's shape? Yes, these are the corners in Meenu's shape. How many corners are there in total? Two. So children, is Meenu's shape correct? No, that's because her shape has two corners. Come, let us have a look at Bablu's shape. Can you look out for the edges in Bablu's shape? Yes, these are the two curved edges in Bablu's shape. Can you look for the corners in this shape? Perfectly correct. In Bablu's shape, the curved edges can never meet. That is why Bablu's shape has no corners. So, is Bablu's shape correct? Yes, Bablu's shape is absolutely correct. Bablu has won the game. Children, in this lesson, we saw some common mistakes related to the edges and corners of shapes. Hello children, in this lesson we will learn about the tiling patterns made from different shapes. Appu has come to Duck Uncle's shop to buy a shirt for his birthday.
uncle is showing him shirts with different designs.
Look, aren't all these shirts beautiful?
Children, do you see something unique in the design of these shirts?
Yes, here shapes are being repeated again and again.
What do we call this?
Absolutely right. We call it a pattern.
Appu loved the shirt made with the yellow flower pattern. He took the shirt from uncle and started to walk towards his home.
When Appu was going home with his shirt, he saw a certain kind of pattern of tiles on the path.
Appu started thinking how this pattern would have been made.
Just then, Sher Khan was passing by on way to his house. Appu asked Sher Khan if he could tell him how this pattern would have been made.
Children, can you tell how these patterns on the floor are made?
No. Come, let's learn it from Sher Khan.
Sher Khan said to Appu that this is very easy. The tiles are joined in a manner that there is no gap left in between the tiles.
Children, is this possible?
Come, let's take on one tile from the pattern on the floor.
How can we attach these tiles to make the pattern on the floor?
Yes, we can make this pattern by arranging these tiles horizontally like this, then vertically, and then again horizontally, and so on.
Appu enjoyed making patterns with the tiles. He thanked Sher Khan and bought some curvy shaped tiles to make a beautiful pattern on the floor of his house.
Appu reached home and with great excitement started making patterns with tiles bought from the market.
He tried hard using Sher Khan's method, but he was unable to create the pattern.
Children, can you help Appu make a beautiful design from these tiles?
Make sure not to leave any gap in your design.
Yes, we can make a beautiful design in this manner with no gap in between using Appu's tiles.
Appu is so happy to see his new floor that he is dancing with joy.
Children, in this lesson, we learnt about tiling patterns made from different shapes. In the next lesson, we will learn about some more interesting examples.
Children, in the previous lesson, we learnt about tiling patterns made from different shapes. In this lesson, we will learn more about this through interesting examples. Sher Khan, Chanda and Babban have come to Appu's birthday party. On seeing the design made with tiles on Appu's floor, they also thought of using such tiles to make beautiful designs in their house. The party got over and everyone went back home.
Next day, Chanda bought these types of tiles from the market. The shopkeeper had told Chanda that she could use tiles with such shape and make this type of design. But Chanda is unable to make this design. Children, can you help Chanda make design by making use of the tiles with this shape? Yes, we can make this design by turning and joining the tiles in this manner. Chanda is very happy to see the design of her new floor. Come, let's see what Sher Khan is doing. Sher Khan has made these types of designs on three walls of his house. Children, can you tell me which tile has Sher Khan used for which design? Well done, children. You have identified it correctly. Chanda and Sher Khan's houses are looking very beautiful indeed. Come, let's see how Babban is doing. Hey, what is this? Babban has slept after making the pattern on just half of the wall. Children, can you help him by completing this pattern? Wow! Children, you have completed it correctly. Babban has woken up. Look how happy he is looking at his beautiful wall. Children, in this lesson, we saw some interesting examples of tiling patterns made from different shapes. Children, in the previous lesson, we saw some interesting examples of tiling patterns made from different shapes. In this lesson, we will cover some misconceptions related to this. One day, Babban was going home. On the way, he stumbled upon something. When he looked down, he saw that one of the tiles of the floor was raised. The tiles made a pattern like this. When he tried to set the tile back on the floor, he saw a golden vessel under those tiles. Babban took out some other fixed tiles from the floor as well. Finally, he took that golden vessel out. He saw lots of gold coins inside it. Babban thought that he will bring a big bag the next day and will take away that treasure. He hid that vessel back under the ground. But he was not able to understand how the tiles were fixed on the floor. He placed the tile like this and went home happily. Children, can you tell me what is the difference between the patterns of the tiles made by Babban and the pattern of tiles already present on the floor? Yes, in the pattern made by Babban, there is some space between two tiles, whereas there was no space in the previous pattern of the floor. Babban had used the same tiles that were already fixed on the floor. Then why did this happen? Some shapes are such that they can be joined in only one way, so that no space remains between them. When Babban went home from there, Golu arrived on the same path. Golu looked at the tile placed on the floor and found that there was a lot of empty space between the tiles. When Golu bent and picked up a tile, he also saw that golden vessel. He removed all the tiles laid by Babban. Just like Babban, he also saw a lot of gold coins inside that vessel. Like Babban, Golu also decided to come and take away that treasure the next day. As he tried to relay those tiles, some of the tiles broke. Now Golu had an idea. There were some tiles at his home. He quickly got them. Golu's tile were of this shape. Golu is thinking how he can make a design with them so that no space remains between two tiles. Children, can you think of any such design? That's right. We cannot make any such design using this shape so that no space remains between two tiles. Remember, children, there are many shapes like this one which cannot be used to make designs which have no space between them. Golu kept trying the whole night, but he could not make a pattern with those tiles. In the morning, a big crowd had gathered around Golu, and he had to share the treasure with all those people. Children, we saw some misconceptions related to the tiling pattern made from different shapes.